the Lakers all decked out as they made their way off the bus and into the arena earlier on. And the game arrival, sponsored by Express. Dress like a pro. The famous We Love Houston sign just off Interstate 10. We're coming to you from the Toyota Center in the biggest city in the Lone Star State. Welcome, everyone, to Noche NBA. A Latin theme is the backdrop to tonight's festivities. Kevin Harlan here with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, and we'll have David Aldridge filling us in from the sideline. We're going to break in the action, so let's take a look at the West and how the teams are stacking up. Look at the Lakers. They are the favorite right now to lock up the number one seed in the playoff tie. They're in first place right now and not looking like they are going to be slowed down at all. And, of course, there's the Rockets, and they're down four spots from them.
And, you know, Houston, this hasn't been the breakout season that many were predicting, but they're still very much in the hunt for a high postseason seed, and that will keep them focused here during the season's final stages.
And they need to stay focused. I mean, they have to ensure they hang on to a high seed. It's imperative for them.
Here are the starters for Los Angeles. LeBron and Green make up the backcourt. JaVale McGee is out there with Davis, and it's Caldwell Pope, and it's the three, the small forward. And for Houston, Westbrook and Harden, the dynamite pair. They're the backcourt. Robert Covington out there with P.J. Tucker. And it's House, and it's the three spot. And if there was ever a definition of a blue guy, Greg, it would be P.J. Tucker. He's so valuable to his team.
You know, P.J. gives you production in every way, and his impact really goes beyond the stats. All the little things that coaches want their players to do, that's really the model of Tucker's game.
Harden finds Westbrook. Here's Tucker. And that comes off the assist by Russell Westbrook.
Love the attitude of Westbrook. Continues to improve at running the offense and finding ways to create opportunities for his teammates.
Ball's knocked loose. And so Westbrook will bring it up for the Houston Rockets. Here's House. And Davis sends it back. Here's the fast break. Davis leading the way. And he makes the bucket, gets the whistle. And now a three-point play chance here for him.
No surprise there. I mean, realizing he has the size advantage, he exploits it perfect.
On the trade for Anthony Davis, a risk for the Lakers. But they feel, Greg, that both sides will find an extension this offseason.
There is mutual interest from both sides. Lakers made the trade confident Davis would resign. A bit of a leap of faith, but the Lakers did everything they could to secure Davis long term.
Here's McGee. Count the basket.
And boy, for a 7-footer, he's got really good bounce, does JaVale McGee, and doing a nice job working on the glass there.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
And it's continuous. Caldwell Pope with the foul. That's his first foul.
That's his first personal foul.
Angeles on D. It's a three-point game.
You know, currently they're just one of five from the field. That's not going to get it done.
They get it again. Davis up and in. Off to an efficient start. 2 for 3 from the field.
Just so resourceful as a player. Davis gets the job done inside in all sorts of ways. And that's one of them right there, crashing the offensive glass, getting that second chance bucket.
Now we'll go to David Aldridge, who spoke with Mike D'Antoni. David.
Well, Kevin, look, he thinks their long-range shooting can make all the difference, not taking anything away from the defense they're going up against. He did say he'd be surprised if his guys didn't shoot a high percentage from outside. Pretty confident coach, Kevin.
Thank you, David. You know, hard to create spacing without the threes. And now the first timeout called here for the Rockets. The Lakers beat them last time when these two teams met in Los Angeles. And it's the Rockets with the ball. Here's Westbrook on target from 13 feet.
And it's the fearlessness of Westbrook. It's really refreshing to watch. When he's deep inside, he just goes right at you.
Now, here's Caldwell Pope taking a look at his stats. He's averaging around 9.5 points a game.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic and is a big part of why they've been able to get these good looks.
So here's Westbrook on the wing, Harden. And that one's a target from the wing. And with the playoffs ahead, some have argued for a play-in tournament, Clark, to determine the 6 through 10 seed. What do you think of that?
An interesting concept. In theory, it certainly might allow for more teams to be engaged down the stretch. You know, with Adam Silver, he's very much interested in seeing how to make the game better in every way. There are no sacred cows. Just because it's been done one way before doesn't mean that he's not looking at ways to change it for the season.
And keep that fan base really interested.
Yeah, that's a big part of what's made the league as successful as it has been worldwide.
And so here is Houston, following the three by the Lakers. McGee with the clock.
Boy, and the wingspan McGee has covers a lot of ground. Very useful for shot blocking.
Trying to get open is Davis, and Green with the basket on the assist by McGee. Green's got his second basket of the night. And let's get your guys take down the hustle stats for the Lakers.
Well, you have to admire their intensity in the paint defensively. I mean, really contesting and even blocking shots is definitely a factor.
And the other thing that's been equally as effective is the fact that they've gotten out on the fast break. A lot of points coming in transition.
And the Lakers decide to take their first timeout here. A good substitution here for the Lakers. Howard's checked in for JaVale McGee. Kyle Kuzma comes in for Davis. Smith checked in for Caldwell Pope. And it's Waiters in for Green. LeBron, that's a two-pointer. Green with the rebound.
Not sure what the team was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him
exactly the ball. And J.R. Smith picks up the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Here's Clemens. Softly dropped in the floater.
How about that wonderful floater he has? Showing off an exquisite touch.
From deep, LeBron. His second make in four attempts.
I think LeBron is best shooting the ball off the dribble. His accuracy, spot on.
And stolen by James. And he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up. And the foul called on the Houston Rockets. Lakers shooting their second and third free throws tonight. First free throw is good. And LeBron James, Clark, climbing the all-time scoring list. Last season passing Michael Jordan. This season, Kobe Bryant. Clark, any chance LeBron someday passes another Laker great, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, for the most career points in NBA history?
I think it's simply a matter of his health, because if he stays healthy, then it's not if, but when. By the time his contract runs out, guys, in 2022, he'll be right in that neighborhood of my all-time favorite player. And I think the greatest player to play, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Displaying intensity right off the opening tip, especially on the offensive end.
Tell you what, forget about easing into the game. They came out with guns blazing.
Green, the shot from the low post is good. Lakers leading by 11. James, the bounce pass. That misses, so no good on his first attempt of the night. And here's the call on home. That's his first foul. Los Angeles foul call. Houston shooting their first free throws of the game on this trip to the line.
And really, the form at the line all season has been terrific. 79% as a team.
Yeah, in general, they've been very solid. I mean, free throw shooting isn't something they've had to worry about too much this season, guys.
He's off on the second.
And that's a rare missed opportunity from him. He'd been good as gold up until that point.
James, he hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
And right from the start, Kevin, they've been pounding the glass. Most of those 50-50 balls also going their way.
Well, I don't think there's any question about it. They came focused and ready to play. I mean, they're doing everything they can to put things in their favor. You earn that, and they're actually earning it well.
And defensively, they're on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Yeah, I think they've got to ramp up the aggressiveness, Greg. I mean, If they don't, things are just going to get worse from here.
Yeah, they're relying on their three-point shooting and getting pretty good results.
Rockets trail by 14. And there's the pass to McLemore. A rebound by the Lakers. Tough loss coming against the Rockets in the last game they played. James has a two-pointer. Rebound by Jeff Green.
Now you can't look at the result of that shot. They'll take that whenever they get it.
Well, you know, I hear you. That's a good look, but when you're that wide open,
on, count,
I think you got to knock it down.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah, and that's four straight field goals now, Greg, they've allowed from point blank range. Can't happen.
And there's the call on home. So that will be his second foul of the game. We're in the bonus. We'll go to the line for shoot two. The Rockets shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night.
At the line for two.
He's perfect from the line this time. Front pass the arc. A shot. No good. So it's LeBron James making things happen for Los Angeles. Scoring, rebounding. He was all over the place during that quarter. They are riding his performance right now. And we'll be right back after this.
Of a game, even when you're struggling at times and you're not shooting the ball particularly well, I just feel like it's going in.
And you know, Greg, that's the type of confidence you gotta have.
The words of a leader. James has proven time and time again that he's dangerous in late game situations.
Los Angeles foul call. We welcome you back to Noche Latina. Becoming an annual tradition is always here on 2K Sports and always exciting. And for the Lakers, this has been the game they wanted to have.
Just stretching out the floor at first. They had the defense scrambling.
And you know what? That's what happens when you establish your three-point game early. Puts the defense right up against it.
Taking a look at Los Angeles. Kyle Kuzma is out there with Smith. And it's LeBron James. Then there's Markieff Morris. And it's Caruso in at the two. Pass to McLemore. They kick it out to Green. And that's going to be a travel. Now a chance, guys, to examine the rebounding numbers over the past months for him.
In the last few months, the rebounding has sort of taken a bit of a dive for him. And a lot of factors could be the cause, but it's a trend that coach would probably like to see him reverse.
And the GOAT conversation. LeBron has said his motivation is to surpass Michael Jordan as the greatest of all time. What do you think he needs to do to bolster his case?
I think for the naysayers, the obvious answer is more weight. You look at the other numbers, including those eight consecutive finals appearances, LeBron is in the discussion.
The Lakers making a switch here. Davis is checked in. Mark, you were such a terrific athlete growing up, and it must be fun for you watching your kids. Soon your grandkids go through their athletic journeys.
It really is one of the great blessings and treats of my life to see our kids grow and develop as people, but also to enjoy different sports. Boys play basketball, soccer, play volleyball, all played in college at some level. So it is great. Anytime you see your kids find their lane, enjoy running in it, and do well in that lane, it's joy and describing.
Shoots the three. That shot off the mark. And the Rockets took it the other way. They couldn't put the pieces together, losing the last matchup with the Lakers. Rivers can't get it to go.
And the activity he shows around the rim is why he was such a respected defender.
And you know what? He's not going to give up an easy finish at the rim. I mean, that's just against his constitution.
Covington wide open. He fires. Kept alive by Houston. Here's Carroll over Smith. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two.
You know, because Carroll is such an aggressive offensive player, that's why he gets these calls.
So for the Rockets, P.J. Tucker comes in for Ben McLemore. And it's James Harden in for Austin Rivers. Caldwell Pope, he's checked in for the Lakers. Green comes in for Smith.
I like the fact he had his head up immediately looking to make the dish down the floor. Get rid of it quickly.
Harden scanning the floor. And here's Covington from the arc. That one drops and he's now 2 for 5.
And they may be leaning a little too heavy on the three-pointer. But when there are better looks to be had inside.
Yeah, and it's one thing when your shots are falling from the perimeter. Anthony, but when you go cold and things aren't going as well, you've got to get that thing inside. Mix it up a little bit.
Knocked away. Caruso, the pass to Davis. Here's Morris. The second effort. And it's Davis laying it in. And now it's a 12-point Los Angeles lead.
And, you know, got to admire the patience inside from Davis. Outstanding. And staying under control, taking his time, and burying the quality shot.
And it's slammed in by Davis.
Yes. Attacking and transition, the most consistent way to generate easy looks.
Yep, exactly. And if there's any opportunity for early offense, you've got to push it and push it every time.
And so here is Houston. After the basket by Los Angeles. And Carroll gets it to go.
He is a legit catch-and-shoot option. Damari Carroll comfortable rising up as soon as he gets it.
Caldwell Pope for three. Carroll with the rebound. And here's Westbrook. He'll bring it up for the Houston Rockets. Down by 12. The three from Harden.
Harden has the ultimate green light. It's uber green, including launching from outside of the state.
And Caldwell Pope gets the basket. And just over 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Now here's Westbrook. He's guarded closely. And there's the foul. Alex Caruso. That's foul number two for him. Daniel House has checked in for Damari Carroll. JaVale McGee's checked in for the Lakers. Here is House. He's guarded by Caldwell Pope. Takes it off to Covington. For three, Westbrook. The Lakers with the rebound. They'll host the Denver Nuggets after this one. That game will be a quick pit stop before hitting the road again. And it's slammed in by Davis.
How about the leaping ability of Davis? Easily gets off the ground to throw it down. And he's a quick jumper and decision maker.
Rockets trail by 13. Inside, here's Covington. That's good. So Westbrook gets a little assist. Westbrook's got his fourth assist in this one.
And boy, has he picked it up since the start of the second. His shots now starting to fall.
Houston's gone 2 for 5 from three-point land since the end of the first. Harden, no good. Lakers leading by 11. There's Green with the three. It's good from long range. Green's got 8 points.
And Green is a world-class sniper, laser, an excellent shooter. Great at getting his puppy set on these shots from deep. Picking up his second foul here, has to be careful because they can pile up quickly.
And Greg, when you're discussing and comparing James Harden and what he's done these last 2 years, you have to do it on a very historic level.
He's going to go down as one of the best to ever play the game. His production is incredible, and the skill level really is groundbreaking. Easily the best off guard in the league.
You know, no matter how you feel about James Harden, you've got to respect his love for the game. I mean, he absolutely lives and breathes basketball, and that passion has driven him to become the player he is today.
Catching up on the changes for Los Angeles. Howard's checked in for Davis. Waiters comes in for Danny Green. And James subbed in for Alex Caruso. Waiters no luck. It's trailed by 12. And Clark, last year, Harden was quoted as saying, most players don't really love basketball.
Well, I don't know
know about most. That seems a bit extreme. Maybe he feels that they don't love it as much as he does, which certainly we could understand. But I can say that very few players have the drive and determination to improve their game the way Harden has. That's part of why he's been an MVP.
And so it's Houston with it, following the basket by LeBron James. And James Harden good for three. Harden's got it back down to a single-digit deficit for the Rockets. Waiters dishes to LeBron. Hits the three-point bomb, James. He's got 17.
That's a big turnaround right there. LeBron answering right back with the three. He knows momentum is in the balance, and he wants it to swing his way. Already, he's looking at his third foul. I think the coach will probably let him sit him down until the third quarter.
For Houston, they have gone 6 of 9 at the line. First free throw is good.
And really a good job of getting to the line in that first quarter. Hasn't been doing that as much here in the second.
Catching up on the changes for Los Angeles, Kyle Kuzma comes in for JaVale McGee. And J.R. Smith subbed in for Caldwell Pope.
Not quite enough defense. That time around, just makes him out. He was off.
And J.R. Smith picks up the foul. That's his third foul so far. Bonus situation in effect, so we'll head to the free throw line for two.
Shooting
free throws. Have attempted 11 free throws today and converted 8 of them.
Taking two shots.
Job getting to the line here. You know, he didn't have a single attempt in that first quarter because I thought he was tentative. Much more aggressive here in the second.
McLemore's checking for P.J. Tucker.
Making it look effortless. Send this guy to the stripe, he's going to cash in more than not.
The shot's good from Smith.
Boy, you're playing with fire. Anytime you leave somebody open on James' team, I mean, LeBron, his court vision, outstanding.
And there's the call on home. That's his third foul so far. On the situation in effect, so we'll head to the free throw line for two. For Houston, they had shot 10 of 13 from the free throw line. Hits one, then misses the second attempt from the free throw line.
And you know, the beard continues to impress, continues to get better, and MVP candidate seemingly every season. Now, I got a question, though. How does he maintain the look of that beard?
Oh, what terrific hustle. He's got a nose for the rebound.
Great, he's ferocious when the ball goes up.
That's what they've got him out there for, fella.
And so it's Los Angeles, holding on to an 11-point cushion as we get ready to take a break. They're feeling very confident, shooting the ball with great efficiency and dictating the pace. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thank you, Kevin, here with Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. Kentavious, you guys were getting a lot of offensive rebounds in the first half. How important was that?
It's important, man. We got to keep them on the glass. We can't give them second shot. We got our offensive rebounds as well. Get us an second chance at the basket. Keep working hard.
Well, you made it work in the first half, KCB. Thanks a lot. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. And stay with us, folks. We'll be back just after halftime to get the third quarter started.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, folks. Ernie Johnson here with Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. It's the NBA on 2K Sports, and let's talk the first half. A tremendous game we're seeing from Anthony Davis. He ended up with 19 points, 2 block shots, and 4 rebounds. And taking a look at the Lakers, Shaq, what you think?
They did an awesome-orific job. That's right, Ernie. Awesome-orific. That's awesome and terrific together. Anyway, they did an awesome-orific job of limiting turnovers. They were almost mistake-free. Put you in the right frame of mind when you play like that. As long as they keep protecting the ball in the next two quarters, it will protect the lead.
How about you, Kenny? What did you think about Houston?
I thought they had a lack of intensity defensively. They gave up way too many threes. I mean, somebody needs to pull out the fire. Because this fire is out of control, and it certainly wasn't because of their defense.
And that'll do it for our halftime report. Stay tuned for the second half, about to get underway. Well, we've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive. And it probably has to happen quickly. You know, Davis has been exceptional here, guys.
And he
was an absolute monster on the offensive glass in that first half. I don't know how you slow him down.
And you know what, guys? I think it starts with having a body on him every time a shot goes up. I mean, they've got to do a better job boxing out.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. Rockets trailed by 11. Westbrook and Harden, the dynamite pair. They're the backcourt. Covington out there with PJ Tucker. That's House in the three. That's the five for Houston right now.
You will not see that from him very often, especially right at the rim.
Here's Green. Good, and the assist goes to James. Green's got the opening bucket to start the second half for Los Angeles. And it's Westbrook with the ball. He brings it up for the Rockets. Trying his luck from deep. But they recover it. Here's Tucker. And they convert it last on attempt number three. Tucker's got his third bucket of the night. Davis in the corner. Three-pointer. Good for the basket. Number nine. He's only missed two shots from the floor all night. Mark, you know, some players just don't need a lot of rest. They can play basketball all day, every day, and don't want to be taken out. They've all got a lot of engine in them.
Yeah, they do. 24-7 guys, we call them. They don't need a lot of fuel, and it seems like they never are out of fuel. Guys like Paul George and Russell Westbrook come to mind.
Mm-hmm. That makes three in a row to start the second half.
And here's Westbrook from the arc. The rebound by Caldwell Pope.
And there have been some terrible shot choices here, Kev. That's not a good look at all. And really, as the three-pointers keep dropping, you get the sense that the frustration is mounting for the defense.
Yeah, and they either have been unwilling or unable to take that shot away.
Harden gets the bucket.
Boy, it's amazing to me how easy Harden makes it look. I mean, when he's locked in, he feels like there's nobody that can guard him. And he's right most of the time.
But only the first miss of the second half. They've come out here with authority.
Wasted no time on that one. Harden's got 18 points in the game.
Harden coming off a big game. His confidence couldn't be higher. And Coach Jones
showing no signs of slowing or cooling down. They're going to ride him as far as he can take him.
And it's JaVale McGee with the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Damari Carroll's checked in for Houston. Austin Rivers comes in for James Harden. The Lakers also with a sub. Morris is checked in for JaVale McGee. Bounce pass for Westbrook. Covington finds Westbrook. Carroll. Good. Nice assist for Westbrook. Westbrook's got assist number 7 for him tonight.
Such an impressive all-around player. Carroll is good at scoring in the painted area as well.
And it's good for two.
Yeah, he's shown terrific control of the pace and the rhythm of this offense.
You know, numbers don't always tell the story, guys, but his assist totals do paint the picture here. He's got everybody involved.
Strong move to the 10, trying to get his guys going.
Hard not to get motivated, GA, right when your teammate makes that kind of play.
And you know, when you're looking to close the gap, you need guys who will take it upon themselves to step up, take the initiative to make something happen.
Russell, the shot's good from Westbrook.
And Westbrook is a terror from the mid-range. Terrific at sticking it to the defense from that spot on the floor.
Boy, that is a bunch of rebounds for a player who's not the biggest guy out there.
Here's Rivers, and the rejection by James. And as it goes out of bounds, Houston able to keep the ball. Houston making a switch. McLemore is checked in. And then for Los Angeles, Howard's checked in for Davis. Kyle Kuzma comes in for Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. And it's Waiters in for Danny Green. Now here's Rivers. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Deion Waiters with the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Green is checked in for Houston.
Jeff Green!
Here's Green, trailing by 13. And there's the call on Howard. That will get him his fourth foul of the game.
That foul gives him four, so he's got to settle down a bit.
And so is Houston with it. And that one's good. Green. Green's got his second basket.
Boy, that was a sweet-looking teardrop. There's very little defense for that.
Waiters for three. Good, and the assist goes to LeBron. And the Lakers lead by 14.
And those aren't the type of three-point opportunities that you can allow in the NBA.
You're exactly right. I mean, those come back to bite you every time, just like it's biting them now.
There's the three. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Earlier in the game, they had a 19-point lead. Here's Waiters. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Waiters got 5 points so far.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Boy, the defense looks shell-shocked. I mean, they're on the ropes right now, on their heels.
Now here's Rivers. He's averaging just around 8 points a game.
I love the ball movement. Put that on a silver platter. Just served him up.
Los Angeles leading by 13. You know, at this point in his career, Austin Rivers has proven how deadly he can be as a weapon club off the bench.
Yeah, you know, Kevin, I like the energy that Rivers comes in with. I mean, he pushes the tempo, looks for a shot as well. And I think he can play either guard spot effectively.
Los Angeles calls timeout.
Every timeout, a chance to review the lineups, matchups, or call a play.
And I agree. I think there's going to be a new wrinkle in their game plan when they come out of this timeout.
Was checked in for Damari Carroll and James Harden subbed in for Austin Rivers. J.R. Smith checked in for the Lakers. Alex Caruso comes in for James. The shot's good from Kuzma.
Kuzma excellent at using his height and touch to perfection. Very confident player.
And this was a call on home. White, that will be foul number five on him.
That's really a tough call. One you don't like to see, but it was called.
Tucker.
Now he's got to really make sure that he's on top of his game here in regards to not picking up another foul. That was a Smith right there.
P.J. Tucker is just in for Houston.
They're consistently finding ways to get the ball inside and taking full advantage.
Pretty clear, a smash mouth basketball. Pound that thing inside.
Howard can hit. Gets trailed by 11. Mr. McLemore.
Shot, and that's James the ball in single digits. He has five.
You have to love the unselfishness on display there. Excellent pass.
Outside Howard. The rebound by Harden. And so it's Harden bringing it up for Houston. Goes up on the wing. That's good for McLemore. On the assist from Harden. And that's now 7 points for Ben McLemore. Lakers leading by seven. Here's Caruso. This is the three. Fast break for the Rockets. Harden's got the ball. That one is good again.
Chris.
He's straight from the floor with the basket.
You know, when you get a clean look at the rim, Harden usually will find you. I think he's underrated and undervalued in making his teammates better.
Now here's Waiters. He's got five. 16 seconds left in the third quarter. Gets it out to Harden. No one near him. Good. It's Harden with the assist that time. Harden's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Caruso, the pass to Waiters, takes a three. And nails it just in time.
One eye on the rim, one on the clock. What a play.
An ideal way to end the quarter with momentum on your side.
And so it's the Los Angeles Lakers with their lead standing at 6 points here at the end of the quarter. From beyond the arc, they've been absolutely tremendous. We've got more in store for you right after this. Take a look back to Mike D'Antoni talking to his team from the huddle.
Come on, guys. Come on. Play our game. Play our game. Get in, Norm. Play our game. Come on now. Let's go. Let's go. We got to settle down.
You can tell they don't think his team is playing like themselves.
And they aren't. They just seem a step slow at this point. And Coach D'Antoni is just trying to energize them.
Well, what a terrific game it's been so far, with this fourth quarter sure to bring more pressure-packed basketball. And on the court for the Lakers to start the fourth. Howard is out there with Kyle Kuzma. And there's Deion Waiters. And it's Smith. And it's Caruso. He hits the point. Here's what the Houston Rockets schedule looks like. On Sunday, they'll be facing Hassan Whiteside and the Portland Trail Blazers. Then on Tuesday, they'll be matching up with Andre Drummond and the Cleveland Cavaliers.
And just looking ahead to what's on tap, there are a lot of winnable games.
Caruso drills the three-pointer. Caruso's got the first basket as we get going in the fourth for the Lakers. And guys, what do you think about the hustle stance for the Lakers?
Contested shots and block shots. They're bread and butter defensively. They're giving up no easy looks.
And also, guys, they take a lot of pride in their ability to rebound the basketball, especially on the offensive end. The defense, a step slow, you can see the result.
Greg, that's three in a row from out there now. They've got to do a better job contesting.
And there's the foul. Here going Alex Caruso. That's his third foul of the game. And Los Angeles with some changes. JaVale McGee's checked in for Howard. Anthony Davis comes in for Kyle Kuzma. And it's green in for Alex Caruso. Just over a minute played here in the fourth. The three from Harden. Buries it for the three-point lead. Harden's got 21.
He's putting on a commanding performance here. He's hit 2 3-pointers in each half now.
From deep, green. And again, Los Angeles with the triple. A lot of players keep track of their stats, their own team stats. But Clark, how much do guys pay attention to stats in-game?
I have no idea. I mean, I know stat sheets are given to the coaches during the timeouts throughout the game, but I don't think players in general are able to monitor their numbers. Now, there are exceptions to every rule. I mentioned every team may have a player or two that can chart his numbers during the game, but the vast majority are too occupied with playing the game to keep up with the stats.
And they're looking up at the scoreboard, too, aren't they? Because they give individual stats up on the board.
Oh, man. Yeah, I tell you that, and then watching replays is one of my pet peeves with players. I mean, they should just focus on playing the game instead of always looking up to see if they foul.
Here is Harden. Deion Waiters making his last shot. Pounds the pass to Westbrook. Sinks the triple.
And it took a long time for him to get that first triple, but let's see how that works.
Violation is going to be reviewed. Coach has issued the coach's challenge to get it analyzed further.
And you know these types of plays, especially when you're talking about action around the sideline, this is something you can get a much better perspective of on replay than real game speed.
We've got the benefit of new camera angles, Greg. Much easier to see exactly what's going on, especially with the fidelity and angles that we've got access to now. So we just got word from the NBA Replay Center via the official courtside administrator. LeBron comes in for Wavers. Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, reporting from the sideline.
Thanks, guys. I was able to hear Frank Vogel talk to his team during the break. He's encouraged where they are at this point in the game, but he told his guys things can turn in a blink. What we need to do is execute the rest of the way. So we'll see if they can finish this one off, Kevin.
Harden has a wide open look. No good on the three.
Well, I'll tell you what, he's going to buy himself a ticket to the bench if he keeps shooting it like that. He has been putrid here this quarter.
Rockets trail by 9. The dish to Tucker. It's good. The assist this time is with Harden.
2 points.
Harden's got 5 assists in the game.
And though lacking some height, Kevin, Tucker has bounce, the reach, and the strength and attitude to do damage inside.
They grab their own miss. The shot's good from the Kings.
And while they have the lead, they're not doing nearly as much work on the offensive boards as they did in that first half.
Timeout called, the Rockets. You have to like what we're seeing from Davis.
Boy, he's been killing them all night, and the defense looks like it's practically packed it in.
And now we get the chance to present our Jordan player of the game, Anthony Davis.
And in terms of his shooting, this has been one of the more accurate performances you'll ever see. I mean, he's been in constant motion, creating a lot of good looks for himself,
But still, even when you're wide open, you expect to miss some of the time. And that has not been the case here tonight. This guy has made everything.
He's really seemed to fit off the hostile environment he's been faced with tonight.
Yeah, the first half was one to deep six or forget. But in the second half, he's looked a lot better.
And here's James outside. It's rebounded by you. Tucker's got rebound number nine now. What an effort from Tucker.
Here's McGee. From outside, off the mark. And it's Houston's ball. Big run right now going for him. 11-2.
Also making some changes. Jared Dudley's checked in for Davis. Deion Waiters comes in for Danny Green. And Quinn Cook subbed in for Kentavious Caldwell-Pope.
Hey, you know, guys, McGee has won back-to-back titles with the Warriors. You know, that's not too bad for a journeyman.
Here's Clemens. A rebound by the Lakers.
And, guys, not sure where his head was on that shot. Not what this offense was designed to create.
Not at all. I mean, that's where they want him, looking for a teammate, not trying to do it on his own. He needs to share the wealth there.
3 seconds separate the shot clock and game. Caboclo, the bench defenders, and the dunk by Chandler.
You know, the athletic game of Chandler helps tremendously. He's awesome. He's flying up to complete alley-oops.
And here are the Lakers. They lead by 11. Shots good by Waiters.
And they came in determined to take this one. It's going to be a happy flight home.
Yep, to have a stress-free win on the road, very satisfying. The fans are already headed for the exit. So
So it's Los Angeles winning this one easily. And in the win, a comfortable win in what was, I think, a pretty hostile environment.
It really was. You know, it's never going to be easy on the road, but they didn't have too many problems with that tonight.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Kevin, thank you. Anthony, an impressive win, and it seemed like a collective effort out there tonight.
Guys came in and stepped up and played tremendously. You know, so I just go out there and play, you know, with all my energy and everything I had in me and leave it out on the floor, and Raph got the win.
Hey, Anthony, thanks for your time. Kevin, back to you, man.
All right, David, thank you. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching this presentation of the NBA on 2K Sports. So long and good night, everyone.